If a girl said, I want you to marry me, but I don't want to clean and cook, would you say yes or no?
No.
Okay, simple as that.
Most women, and I'll say this much, and I even know of some of them, women who have high value men, who when they thought they were going to lose the man, they turned around and they had a kid because they thought, yeah, if I have a kid with him, he won't leave.
Welcome to Above Light channel. So today I'm with my brother Jill. For those people who don't know Jill, basically we've been talking about business and self-improvement, everything for a long time.
For all you guys out there, my name is Giovanni. I'm a business consultant. I am now a cannabis entrepreneur, also heavily invested in real estate. I suppose for the purposes of the manosphere, I would be what you consider a high value male. I make 7 figures a year. My wife also makes about 7 figures a year. So ultimately, yeah, that's who I am.
So because of your background, I think it's very useful. I think it's very valuable for us to know your perspective or your opinion. Because the original post is deleted by the original author already. But right. some other guy, you know, he just kind of summarized the stuff. Yeah. Original, let's call it a woman. She is more than 30 years old already. And she is taller than 170 centimeters.
Okay, so she's right? Above the height for a female.
Yeah, yeah. So for the Taiwanese people, she's pretty high, actually. And she claimed herself is an 8. And she's outgoing. She's having fun all the time. You know, she likes to have some adventure. And she studied abroad for a long time. So probably she has a very good degree.
Most likely she has different cultural experiences. So exposure brings knowledge. So she's probably coming at the situation with a Western perspective. Mm-hmm.
And her annual salary is about 2 million. So
right.
I would say she's about like 100K to 150K compared to US country. And now she's trying to find a guy or a man who is more than 30 years old. But she doesn't want to have a kid. Okay, so she has a requirement. Her question is there a guy exists like this? So first, the guy should be an 8. I don't even know what that means.
The thing is this, right? A lot of men out there aren't going to want to admit that, or at least based on social standards, that Brad Pitt might be a 10, right? Everybody has their own, you know, view of what they think what is. So she probably is coming off of that based on a Brad Pitt / Giga Chad type view. Yeah, she wants a guy who is at least an 8. Yeah.
And then his annual salary is also about like 2 million Taiwanese dollars. So it's approximately 100K to 150K. Just giving an idea, right? He has to be a manager and no work overtime. And he has to be in love with adventure, reading, and a lot of hobbies.
Based on the conditions that she's putting forward, he needs to be her. That's all she's saying. She's saying he should be her.
Yeah,
because
somehow,
somehow she fits all those steps. And then she's ultimately saying, based on the conditions, if you're someone who has to work overtime, then it means that you're not necessarily in control. You're not the boss. It means that you don't have the time to take her all the different places that she would like to go to.
And he should have his personality, hobbies, and with a good social skill. Okay. The good social skill, I think it's somehow a little bit harder for Asian people compared to, you know, the typical Western people, I would say.
Which is why I think she's definitely looking at it with a Western overview, because she spent time in Western culture. So she understands the value behind social skills. But traditionally, Asian people are a little bit more withdrawn. So I understand that.
Mm-hmm. We are more humble, you know, we are more like working hard. And he can communicate with foreigners, you know, associations, something like that. But the thing is, she wants a house, which is cost around 30 millions. And she doesn't want to cook. She doesn't want to do the cleaning. She wants to have the maid. So basically, that's her requirement, you know?
So that's a whole lot of background. So what I'm going to do is this, right? I'm going to break it down in the simplest term that I possibly can. What you find happening more often than not, right? the women who have all these requirements are the ones who stay single the longest. Male or intersexual dynamics aside, what you find happening is this. A lot of women who prize themselves on success, they basically take what would be the best years that they have, the I'm super hot, fine years, and put that into keeping their heads down and trying to climb that corporate ladder if they're not entrepreneurs. Then when they do, when they attain a certain level, something in them triggers this switch. It's a competitive switch that says, the man that I'm with needs to be like me or better. Point of the matter is this, right? Naturally speaking, based on how we are designed, we are the hunter-gatherers. We provide. Women are supposed to nurture. But it's the 21st century now. Things have changed, right? Women want to be alpha females, and men want to, well, in some cases, not be men. And they're just not stepping into the roles that they're supposed to play. So what you're going to find happening is a lot of women are going to keep these newer standards, right, that they have. But the thing is this, they keep the newer standards that they've made for themselves, but still expect the old school standard that existed for men. They don't think that men should change. So when they look at the socioeconomic structure, they think what's mine is mine. And then they think what's his is also mine, but his. That's how they look at these things. She wants to be a new age woman with a traditional man. For me, what I've said to many of my friends is this, you know, being an entrepreneur, I said to them, you're either going to live in balance with a successful woman, or you are going to babysit a lazy one. In her case, she's successful, but she's successful and she wants to be babysat at the same time. She doesn't want to build with you. She wants to be successful and be taken care of.
And do you think that her expectation is somehow fit the reality?
So the thing is this, right? Based on societal norms now, it's not unrealistic, but is it attainable? That's where the difference is. New school women don't have traditional standards. Traditional standards for women was they take care of the house, you go out and you make money. New school women want to make money, but they want to be taken care of at the same time. So she wants to have, as they would say, she wants to have her cake and eat it too. So what you have to look at is it attainable? The fact of the matter is this, unless every man somehow wakes up tomorrow and realizes that they've been missing something in their lives and starts going after what is that perceived high value flex, which is, you know, quitting my job, starting my own business, or attaining the highest rank in my business, which you can still be an employee and be a high value man just the same because you're making money. If someone's even a doctor, you're not an entrepreneur. You work for the fucking hospital unless you have your own private practice, and then you're an entrepreneur.
But her requirement is like no working overtime. And
exactly. So then even a doctor who is generally considered a high value man is also not fitting her category because what? The doctor is always on call.
Her requirement is like the guy has to be taller than 180.
So then she came back.
Around 180 is about 6 foot. I don't know how to.
Somewhere thereabout. Now what she's done is this, right? She's come back to a traditional Asian community where not everyone is the tallest person in the world. You know,
I would say only 10% or maybe less than 20%, 10% of men can be taller than 180 in Taiwan.
Exactly.
So
she's come back to the wrong place with the wrong values and the wrong conditions to try and say.
And I will ask you this. So what kind of guy she can get?
To answer that, like statistically speaking, even if you want to get down to the brass tacks, look at the information that's available. And there's a government body or there's some organization that's capturing these numbers. Statistically speaking, her chances are very slim. Now, the problem with that is this, right? In her mind, any man that she finds, she's settling. She's lowering her bar. And what is now the case is that most women who make a certain amount of money, they consider it dating down, and they don't want to have to date down. Now, the funny thing is this, they will sleep down. They will have sex with somebody who is not in that category for a good time, but they're not going to date down or marry them, right? Generally speaking, women like them end up, you know, just coursing the dating scene for a very long time until they realize that, you know what, my expectations are too high. And at some point, it dawns on them that what they want is not what they're going to get, and it's not what they need.
There's two things is very crucial, I think. The first thing is she doesn't want to have kids, and she doesn't want to do the cooking and house, whatever. I think that one is a little bit harsh, because I would say a high-value man, they want a legacy.
Even if I throw myself into the field and say, yeah, I'm a high-value man, I didn't get with my wife because I wanted to. We still do go all over the place. We travel together a lot. Perks of being entrepreneurs. We get to go wherever the hell we want to do, go. But at the same time, I made up my mind that I wanted to have a family, right? I wanted to continue my legacy. I didn't get all this stuff so that I can then turn around one day and then when I die, somebody says, hey, the painting should go to a museum. No, it's worth a shit ton of money. It should go to one of my kids, whichever one likes it, whichever one wants it, right?
Mm-hmm.
What she is doing, which funny enough, this is something that Kevin Samuels said to men. He said, don't date women who have marriage and kids in life if you know that that's not where you're at. Mm-hmm. The problem is this, right? Most high value men, as you said, in terms of the continuance of their line, they want to have kids. Most likely they want to have sons, right? So yep. she is going in with the condition of saying, hey, you need to be prepared to not have children. She's going in to tell the man that something that he is naturally geared to do at a certain point in time in his life, he should not want to do anymore. I would suggest that her best bet is to just keep it going. Keep dating, because ultimately speaking, I'm not buying a house for a girlfriend. I'm not paying for a maid to come clean up after a girlfriend. That's babysitting. Yeah. And that's exactly what that is. That's me opening my house like an adult daycare center, because she comes over, she leaves all her dirty laundry all over the place, she eats food, she doesn't want to cook the goddamn food that she's eating, and she doesn't want to clean up after herself. Doesn't that sound like a grown woman child to you? And I don't want to take care of a child.
Yeah, I will ask you this question, right? If a girl said, I want you to marry me, but I don't want to clean and cook, would you say yes or no?
No.
Okay, simple as that, for sure.
Who's going to do it? What she's asking me to do is to find somebody else to do that, which I'm not paying somebody to clean my house. So I'll say this, right? Throughout my entire dating experience, maybe I'll say only up until, I would say, put college in there. When I was at university, I was still dating. I was still dating like a high value man. I'll say that, because the women that I dated from college onward, all of them, they had all the makings of a supportive woman for a high value man, right? They had money, they had assets, all that good stuff. But the one trait that I found between all of them was that they still wanted to cook for me. They still wanted to clean the house. Right? They still wanted to do the things that women do. So
some people say this is some kind of patriarchy, you know, you try to.
Hey, I'm not trying to. See, the thing is this, right? I'm not trying to foster the patriarchy. But guess what? To all the people who say that, right? These women are going to turn around, and all of them, they speak, you know, heavily on some feminist terms. They're going to turn around and they want you as a man to hire a woman to clean their house. They're not going to tell you, oh, hire another man to come clean the house. They're going to tell you to hire another woman to come clean the house. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So what you have to look at it, it boils down to just not wanting to do what you are capable of doing, because they're not going to tell you, hire some men to come clean the house. They're not. They're going to tell you to hire women.
Actually, I was truly thinking for the woman that how she can get, you know, the most possible man she can have. I think there's one thing she has to sacrifice. The man should not be a very good social skill person. He has to somehow very introverted. The reason is this, right? Because there's a chance for her that she can get this high value man. For example, maybe he is a doctor. She studied very hard, but she's introverted. He's not going out. He's not hooking up. So somehow he's high value man, but he's hiding himself. So he is somehow like...
I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
I get where you're coming from. I was going to disagree, but then as soon as I listened to what you were saying, I started to understand because a man that has that level of social skills, right? Someone who's a social butterfly going out, talking to everybody, that man becomes rich with options. And then what that's going to do for her is to create a problem. So yeah, you're right. She would have to give up on some level of the, I suppose, the conditions or the structure of the man.
I'm not saying he is some kind of social awkward. I'm saying he's introverted.
He
wants to be alone and doing his own stuff. He can go to the gym by himself. He can work. He can be working hard. But if his personality is so outgoing, he has to go out and talking to all the women and all the guys.
Yeah,
he has no chance.
Right, because at the point in time that he starts looking at what he has in her, he's going to start evaluating everybody else that he ever interacted with. And he's going to be like, listen, I could get somebody that wants to cook, clean, and do all this stuff that still looks better than you. You know what?
Yep. So I think that that guy will commit to her if she wants to be a feminine role and she needs an introverted man. And that is the highest chance she can get this high value man.
And basically that right there is getting her to go into a lab and cook this person up, because at the end of the day, she's not going to be able to make all those things happen. Like, unless she goes and finds someone who just generally can't have kids. Because it's going to be hard for her to put that across. Most women, and I'll say this much, and I even know of some of them, women who have high-value men, who, when they thought they were going to lose the man, they turned around and they had a kid. Because they thought, if I have a kid with him, he won't leave.
Yep. So before we end this video, we will talk about, you know, how a man can get this kind of high value successful woman. But we will put this video into my golden subscription content, and the link is right below right there. So great, thanks Jill. It's great, you know, to have you here and have your opinion.
All right, it's great being here.
We'll see you guys next time.